This is the BBC.
This podcast is supported by advertising outside the UK.
Hi, I'm Danny Pellegrino from the Everything Iconic podcast. And who doesn't love a classic burger from McDonald's? That's right, McDonald's classic burgers are hotter, juicier, and tastier than ever. The patties are cooked to juicy perfection. I love the cheese perfectly melted on top. I love the Big Mac that has special sauce in every bite. I love the pillowy soft golden bun. So in the words of the Hamburglar,
rubble, rubble,
which I believe means grab McDonald's best burgers ever before Hamburglar does at a McDonald's near you.
Ryan Reynolds here from Mint Mobile. You know, it's hard to believe that inflation is still a thing, but boy, it sure is. And that's exactly why Mint Mobile still gives you premium wireless for just $15 a month. Well, it's also because we have that offer printed on, like, a million T-shirts, but it's mostly the inflation thing. So give it a try at mintmobile.com/switch.
Upfront payment of $45 for 3 months required. New subscribers only. Renew for 12 months to lock in savings. Additional taxes, fees, and restrictions apply. See mintmobile.com.
BBC Sounds. Music, radio, podcasts.
Time for another week of the 10 to the Top podcast and another week of Piano Room Month. Now, we are playing a musical teaser at the start of every podcast. Did you catch Friday's? Let's hear it again. Did you guess correctly? That was Beverly Knight with Shudder Woulda Coulda. And if you missed her incredible Piano Room set from last week, you can catch it all on BBC Sounds and iPlayer. Anyway, it's time for another musical teaser. Don't forget, it'll be one of our Piano Room Month artists. Can you name this song and artiste, please? Ooh, we like that. Let's hear it again. You'll find out the answer in tomorrow's episode. Anyway, you think about that for a while whilst we play the actual quiz. It's time for 10 to the Top.
BBC Radio 2. 10 to the Top.
So, as I always say, on a Monday, it's a brand new week. So we've cleaned the slate. We have 0-0-0 as the top score this week. So let's crack on. Let's see how Gary Walsh does in Saltash, Cornwall. How are you feeling, Gary?
I'm good, Vernon.
Yeah, very good. You enjoy surfing, cold water swimming, jamming with your mates on the guitar? That's a proper Cornwall list right there.
Yeah. Living the good life, you know how it is.
Yeah. How is Cornwall? Just paint the picture as you look out the window.
Yeah, pretty idyllic. Lovely beaches. You can do whatever you want down here. So, yeah, great place to live.
And the fact that you enjoy taking advantage of the beautiful surroundings with your surfing, cold water swimming, and then bring it indoors and start jamming on the bass guitar. Sounds like you're living the dream, Gary.
Yeah, it's not bad. Life's pretty good.
Yeah, good stuff. You like the Foo Fighters? You went to the Taylor Hawkins tribute concert at Wembley.
Yeah, me and my wife and a couple of friends went to see that. Seen them a few times. We're actually going to see them again this year in June at the Olympic Stadium, so really looking forward to that as well.
Yeah, very good. And Jamiroquai is now top of the bucket list.
Yeah, I've been a fan of them for quite some time, but just never got the opportunity to see them. But hopefully things may line up and we'll get to see them.
You once chased Bradley Wiggins up a hill at the Tour de France to shout him some words of encouragement. Which hill was it? It wasn't Mont Ventoux, was it?
No, it wasn't Mont Ventoux. It was La Tussuere, which is in the French Alps. So, yeah, went over there with a few friends on a little cycling trip to watch the tour and ended up on the mountain running up alongside Bradley with the Cornish lag. So it was great.
Awesome. Hey, listen, you're same age as me. I'm about to turn 50 and I'm doing Fit for 50 for myself just because I'm trying to obviously get fit for 50. Any tips, any advice?
Don't let anybody tell you you can't do it. Just go and do it.
I'm ready. Fired up. Let's do it. Are you good? Are you ready to go?
I'm ready to go, yeah.
To the Top on Radio 2.
For 1 point, the UK's biggest selling album in 2018 was from a film that starred Hugh Jackman and Zac Efron. What was that movie musical?
The Greatest Showman.
Yes, it was. You've got a point. There you go.
Ooh, yes.
For 2, There Might Be Giants reached the top 10 in 1990 with which song?
I know the lyrics, but I can't know the song, sorry.
Yeah, this is going to do your head in. Birdhouse in your soul.
Yes, I know. I was thinking of the Blue Canary lyrics.
Yeah. Starts off with not to put too fine a point
on
exactly,
it. Yeah, exactly,
There's a little birdhouse in your soul. There you go. Right, for 1 point, no, because we got that one wrong, this is your first clip, and we're heading all the way back to 1965 for this week's number one by The Righteous Brothers. It's a familiar classic, but what's the title? We had a love you don't find every day.
Is it You've Lost That Loving Feeling?
It was, yes. Made famous, of course, for us young whippersnappers, Top Gun.
Yes, I've never seen that film.
What?
Yeah, I know, probably the only person in history to never see it.
You've never seen Top Gun?
Nope.
An action Jackson person like yourself, who sounds like an adrenaline junkie, you've never seen Top Gun?
Nope.
Wow! Well, there you go. It's on your list now. Here's a question for 2 points. Who sang on 15 top 40 hits in the 80s with his former band, then made his solo debut, here's a big clue, in 1988 with a song called Suede Head?
Simon Le Bon?
It was Morrissey.
Oh, well. Morrissey. Never mind.
Those 15 top 40 hits with the Smiths?
Yes, of course.
In what year did Groovies in the Heart give D-Light their biggest ever hit?
I'm going to go with 1989.
1 year out.
Oh.
1990.
Oh, never mind.
Right, we've got 2 points. We need some more. Come on. For a point. In 1993, the 5 Live EP topped the chart, and it featured a version of Queen's Somebody to Love performed by the remaining members of Queen and which superstar performer?
You're going to have to tell me.
Oh, George Michael!
Oh, of course.
All right, for a point, which group fronted by Stuart Adamson took the songs Fields of Fire, 500 Miles, and Chance into the top 10 in 1983?
I'm drawing a blank on that one, sorry.
It was Big Country.
Oh, no, I wouldn't have known that.
No, I didn't know that either. Right, it's your next clip. Take a listen to this top 10 song from 1982. It came from a Merseyside band whose frontman had a bizarre haircut. But who are they?
I don't think I know it, but I'm going to take a stab at Bauhaus.
No, it's Flock of Seagulls.
Oh, I nearly said Flock of Seagulls. I should have gone with that. Never mind.
Oh. Lead singer Mike's famous haircut came about by accident. It began as a Mohican, but when bass player Frank patted it down before an early gig, Mike just thought, do you know what? I'll go with it.
Yeah, that was a look for sure.
It really was. In 1987, what kind of lights did footballers Glenn Hoddle and Chris Waddle sing about?
Shining lights.
It was diamond lights.
Diamond lights, oh man.
For
See,
a
I'm
point.
Not a football fan, so I'd have never picked up on that one.
Too busy spending too much time outdoors, which is not a bad
thing. Exactly, yeah.
Not a bad thing. For a point, but it's your last question, so we're going to play the Joker. It's now worth 2. In 2014, the number one song, Changing, saw the dance production team Sigma collaborate with which British female singer?
No, don't know that one either.
It was Paloma Faith. We scored 2 points.
Oh, well, that's better than 0, so I'm happy.
Well, I told you you wouldn't get 0.
I know.
I just expected you to get more than two.
My wife will be so disappointed because she's really good at this.
Hey, don't worry, because if our next contestant, who is Andrew Dawson from Bishop Auckland, if he doesn't beat that score of two, then you get the smart speaker. If he does, you get the coffee mug. So it's a win-win.
Oh, cool, win-win, yeah. Gary. I'm good with the coffee, man.
All right, we'll find out how you get on after this.
Hi, we're One Direction.
How did five boys from a talent show become a worldwide phenomenon?
There was a really hungry fan base.
Changing the face of fandom forever.
There was just fans that literally were stopping us even getting to the studio.
I'm Maddie Grace Jepson, and we're the people who made them.
That boy band really has something.
And the people who loved them.
Set aside Niall Horan's house for 6 hours just to catch a glimpse of the top of his hair.
There's just a fire within teenage girls.
This is One Direction, a fan story. Listen on BBC Sounds.
After that little scheduled message, shall we crack on with the quiz? Oh, but before that, if you've forgotten to subscribe, then press the subscribe button now and you'll get episodes of 10 to the Top downloaded directly onto your device. Right, here we go, contestant number two.
BBC Radio 2, 10 to the Top.
Andrew Dawson from Bishop Auckland has two to beat. I know it's a low score, Andrew, but, past couple of days, the question has been quite tricky. So let's see how you do. Now, you love cycling as a hobby.
I do, yeah, love cycling.
Ooh, I've got a decent bike.
Not bad, yeah. It's like just a straight handlebar one. I can't do a racer anymore, so I'll be backing out of it.
I know, I think it's the same for people who ride motorbikes as well. They go from the kind of the speedster bikes, you know, the ones that I guess you'd call it a Barry Sheen bike, the fast ones, and then they slowly start to get upright and they get a tourer as they progress through the years.
Yeah, just like me, except with pedals.
Fair enough. Do you stick to the roads or do you do a bit of off-roading as well?
Roads and tracks, really.
Right.
Not mountain biking, no. Mm.
You love 80s music. This year you got tickets to see ABC. Sounds of the 80s. Rick Astley, what a mix.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, great. No, really good.
Apart from cycling, is there anything else that you like doing in your spare time?
I'm a Sunderland fan.
Right.
So, season ticket holder, so I'll go there every fortnight.
Lovely.
And then we like road trips. We've got a little Mazda, so we go off different places and explore the country, which is good fun.
Yeah, beautiful. Have you been to Gary's part of the world? Been down there in Cornwall?
Yeah, we were down last spring, actually, in Cornwall. It's beautiful. We're near Loo.
Beautiful part of the world, it really is. We like going down there as well.
Yeah, it's lovely. Really nice.
You've got two to beat. Are you ready?
I am.
All right, good luck. Here we go. For 1 point, complete the title of this 1973 number one single by Slade. Come on, feel the... what?
Noise.
For 2 points, Jailhouse Rock topped the chart this week in 1958 for which legendary musician?
Elvis Presley.
It was Elvis Presley, yes. And that song is one of the choices of John Cooper Clarke on Tracks in My Ears this week. We're going to play that on Wednesday. For 3 points, this week in 1998, this Danish band achieved the second of their three UK number ones with this song. Just name the group. It is Aqua, and here's a little known fact for you. The track Dr. Jones is actually a cover version of an old Beatles track which was discovered in a cellar in a house in Amsterdam in 1983.
Never knew that.
No, that's because I made it up, but it sounds ridiculous. But you never know in the crazy, wacky, bonkers world of music. You might imagine John Lennon and Paul McCartney singing this. This bit. Oh, if only.
A little bit slow, maybe.
Well done. It was Aqua. For 4 points, the 1993 single, I Don't Want to Fight, gave which iconic performer her biggest solo hit during the whole of the 90s?
Cher.
No, it was Tina Turner.
Oh, never.
Yeah, unlucky for a point. Dido's biggest ever hit was White Flag, which spent a fortnight at number two. But in what year?
2003?
Yes! Oh, whoa. We have a year question right. Get in there, Andrew, for 2 points. Complete the title of this top three single from 2011 by Allo Black. I Need a What?
Dollar.
For 3 points. What's the one-word title of the 1979 song that gave the Flying Lizards their biggest hit?
Money.
Yes, it was Money. This is your next clip. Here's an American R&B star who's celebrating his birthday today. This was his big tune from 1989's Ghostbusters 2 soundtrack. Who is he? Too hot to handle, too cold to hold. They called the Ghostbusters and they're in control. Had a throwing party for a bunch of children. Well, all the while, the slime was under the building. So they packed up their boots, got a grip, came equipped, grabbed their proton packs off the back, and they split. Found out about a beagle, the master of evil, trying to battle my boy. Bobby Brown. It is! Please tell me that you bought the single or something like that.
No.
You said that way too quickly, though, Andrew.
You got to deny it, haven't you?
Yeah. For 5 points, pretty decent role here, my friend. In 1985, Hanging on a String and Magic Touch were both hits for which London-based soul group?
Loose Ends.
Yes, my friend. For 6 points, but we're going to play a joker because it's your last question. For 12 points now, the dance anthem Rock the House charted in both 1997 and 2001 for the DJ and producer known as Tall Who.
It's not Tall Paul, is it?
It is Tall Paul. Well, that gets you 12 points and it gives you a grand total of 33 points.
Oh, great. Thank you.
Amazing. Yes, well done. What a great way to start the week with a high score like 33. I think it's safe to say, no disrespect to Gary, that you've won the smart speaker. Unlucky, Gary.
Ah, that's fine. I did better on that round. I answered 5 of those right, but well done, Andrew. You smashed
cheers.
It.
Cheers. Thank you, Gary.
You got it, no worries.
Yeah, but Gary, you can do that thing, that stereotypical thing that was made famous in a coffee advert. You can pull up in your van with your surfboard on the roof. You can put your electric water heater in the cigarette lighter socket and you can stick it in your BBC Radio 2 10 to the top coffee mug and sit back, relax and sip your coffee before you dive into the chilly waters off Cornwall.
Will do, absolutely.
Good man. All the best, Gary. Take care. Andrew, congratulations. The smart speaker's in the post, pal.
Lovely. Thank you, Vernon. Cheers.
Cheers, buddy. And if you want to play, then all you got to do is get in touch. It's 08000 288 291. Dead simple. Give us your details. A member of the team will be in touch. And if you've got the email, if you're tapping keys at work, if you're plodding around the office and you've got no do because you've clocked off early, then why not send us an email? 10tothetop@bbc.co.uk.
10 to the top on Radio 2.
BBC Sounds. Music, radio, podcasts.
Hi, I'm Danny Pellegrino from the Everything Iconic podcast. And who doesn't love a classic burger from McDonald's? That's right. McDonald's classic burgers are hotter, juicier, and tastier than ever. The patties are cooked to juicy perfection. I love the cheese perfectly melted on top. I love the Big Mac that has special sauce in every bite. I love the pillowy soft golden bun. So in the words of the Hamburglar, rubble, rubble, which I believe means grab McDonald's best burgers ever before Hamburglar does at a McDonald's near you.